Let me get myself situated because we got to talk about Kandi and the Gang.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to another episode of TDGS Reviews. This is a new series that I'm doing. I'm going to be doing it by myself because, you know, I love the group panel discussions, but, you know, it's you know, trying to figure out everybody's schedule at the same time and trying to get everybody on the channel. I'm going to do it myself, you know, and I wanted to start a new series. Now, you guys have, I did a poll, right? Because I had the intention to only do like one show per month. But y'all are so indecisive in my damn community tab. I asked, I'm like, do y'all want to see me do a series review on Kandi and the Gang or Chasing Atlanta? And y'all picked, it was 50-50. I'm like, oh my, so I'm gonna do both. Okay, so Chasing Atlanta, I keep on calling it LA. Chasing Atlanta is going to be dropping the 23rd of this month. And that's like a couple weeks to wait for. And I'm doing something different with that show anyway. I'm probably going to be doing like live reactions, you know, as it's like, because it premieres live on YouTube and stuff like that. And I could just like easily like, you know, share the screen and all that. So just going to be working on that. But for now, you know, be doing Kandi and the Gang. You know, episode one was, I think it was Meet OLG or something like that. I don't be keeping track of what these episodes be called. Okay. But nevertheless, my first thoughts on the show. Oh, before we get into it, please be sure, hold on, before we get into it, please be sure that if you like this video, hit that like button. If you have a opinion, leave a comment. And also hit that subscribe button if you haven't already did so, and tap the bell to get notified. Because, you know, we need some subscribers. I need to get to 1,000 so we can get on to this creator fund or whatever you call this thing on YouTube so we can get it started. Help me help y'all, honey, because I'll give you some more content. And interact with my community tab. Like, I want to know what you guys like, what you guys don't like, what topics you want me to talk about. I didn't do an episode for the Darren Green Show because this was feeling under the weather. And I'm sorry if y'all hear something on the outside here. You know, people just be wanting to cut down trees out here. But we're gonna keep it moving. Okay. So let's get right into the show. Okay, so my first initial thoughts, right? I thought that the first half of the show was very entertaining. I don't know what happened towards the end. I'm going to be very honest. I'll go tell you what it gave. And I think that the first half of the episode was very entertaining. I think a lot of people were really tweeting at that time. The second half, it could have, you know, it was a little, I don't know, it seemed like they were trying to cram an hour. Or not cram an hour, but like, you know, try to figure out what the tape and like, okay, so we need to fill in an hour. There we go. It just, to me, I didn't really connect with that last part. I was just like, okay, everything is kind of like faltering or something. Like, it's just not working for me. Just my opinion, you know. But tell me what y'all think about it. Did y'all like the full episode? Did you like one part, the first part, more than the other, or the other way around? So, you know, I just felt like the first half of the show was really entertaining. Now, what's going on with production? I've seen a lot of my, you know, mutuals on YouTube talking about it too. A lot of people on Twitter was like, what is going on with these confessionals? Okay. The lighting, the editing. I was like, is Bravo not editing this show? Or is production, is Bravo production? Is this a Kandi coded production? Oh, let me stop. I love Kandi. Look, she does a good job. Wish she do her thing. But like, come on, let's get into it. Is it like, what? I don't know. I mean, production could have been a little bit better, but like, let me not judge, like, you know, the first season. This is the first episode. This is a pilot episode. You know, Kandi has so many pilots, Charm. But you know what? I'm really hopeful. I'm hopeful for this one, okay? I see this being like another, like a Black Vanderpump Rules. I don't want to have those expectations because this might be something completely different, right? The thing about it is, though, I feel like with Vanderpump Rules, like, I don't want to, because it might be something different, right? Like, it's similar to Vanderpump Rules because this is about, like, okay, so Kandi's restaurant and it has another cast of people and then they become its own thing. You know, it kind of is reminiscent of Vanderpump Rules. But, you know, we are hoping that it's a lot better, okay? Because I never got into that show. I watched a couple episodes, but I never really got into that show. But it was very successful. It had a lot of seasons. So hopefully this, you know, this will be, like, a recurring thing for Kandi. And her team. So what I did like, and this is still me talking about the my first initial thoughts, I liked how things were addressed. Okay, we all know OLG had issues. Okay, I heard they was charging people for ice. People was waiting outside for hours upon hours before getting seated. They were failing health inspections. Like, it was some real, you know, shit that was going on, and people was talking about it. And I'm glad that they addressed it and they kept it real. They kept it. They spoke the truth. I will say, Kandi did speak the truth, unlike some of her previous castmates that do spinoffs. Not saying any names, okay, Portia. Anyway, but you know, like, she kept it real, and that's what I liked. Anyway, did y'all see the intro for the damn show?
Bitch, you better be joking.
They said it was giving crispy chicken and lettuce. Not Mary J. Blige at the damn Burger King commercial. What? Anyway, now we're going to get into the timeline. Hold on, let me see if I got my notes together, child. The timeline of the show. Okay, so it starts off with Kandi and Todd talking about OLG, what it's been going through, right? So we figure out what the issue is. The issue is they haven't had a real good general manager since the previous ones left. Okay. And after they left, that's when stuff, you know, started to go downhill. So they hired this guy named Philip, and basically he worked at their other restaurant. It was called Blaze. And essentially, like, he's pretty cutthroat. You know, he did his little touring, and he was, you know, a lot of the coworkers don't like him already, right? Like, he's very militant, and he looked like, I mean, to me, a lot of people find him attractive, but I'm just like, okay, yeah, well, you know, whatever. Anyway, this restaurant needs a shakeup, right? And I feel like, and I have to sometimes blame Kandi and Todd, because they're, you know, you guys are the CEOs. But like, y'all not CEOing, okay? Y'all not picking out what y'all need to pick out. Like, this person cannot work here. We need to get a new this. We need, like, and I think that Philip is going to be the person that's going to shake shit up. Even when we seen like sneak previews of the next episode, or not the next episode, but the season, we see him getting into it with Kandi. You get what I'm saying? I think everybody is at fault here. You know, this is one of those episodes where you hire some expert to come into your restaurant to see what the fuck is going on. It's poor leadership, and it's poor employee. Like, they're like, and I made a tweet and it got a lot of likes or whatever. I said, who hired these people and who kept them? I'm like, I get it, Kandi. Some of these people, your family, but girl, like, what are we doing? So we get like a little moment with one of the hostess. Her name is Chandrika. A lot of people did not like her on Twitter. Like, she was very, she come off very unprofessional. She's very, very much like, you know, I'm here, I don't care what nobody got to say, this, that, and the third. My thing is, you can have that whole persona, honey, but if your work ain't where it need to be, like, come on now. And then saying stuff like, oh, well, you know, I'm not from Atlanta. Like, I'm trying to find myself. Did that. I'm like, child, what are we doing? You was the hostess, honey. You supposed to be the hostess with the mostest, but you're giving very much nothing. You get what I'm saying? So I, you know, I kind of get where Philip was a little, I will say, he was being a little bit too aggressive. Like, he sent that girl home, and he was saying in the confessionals, like, I don't go back and forth with hourly employees. You're a greeter. I'm like, ooh, not a read. Not a read, honey. Did they read the child? I forgot. Yep, they are in Atlanta, child. I'm not, look. And I, to a certain extent, I get where he's coming from, because it's like, you know, this lady has been left. It seems like she's just been left on unchecked. No one's really checking her. Everybody's laughing. Like, the manager that they did have was Brandon, which he just freaking is on his phone and not doing shit. Like, he just, like, what is this? Make it make sense. No one is telling people what to do and how to act. And people are just out there standing out there for hours. Now, I'd be damned. I'd be goddamned. Okay. You see how long them lines are in them episodes? And y'all acting like that? Yeah, he kicked Chandrika out, because, like, girl, what's really going on? Anyway, so Kandi goes over her aunt's house and they start talking about the employee too. So now, you know, as crazy as Mama Joyce is and you know, how her aunts are very opinionated, it is crazy that Mama Joyce is saying some, speaking some truth when she's talking about some of the employees. Like, Kandi, what are y'all doing? This is their, this is your business, Kandi, but this is also like, this is very much like a, you know, it takes a village to raise, you know what I'm saying? Cause like it's OLG, it's their recipes, it's their business too. So it's like to see that they're kind of frustrated with the employees too, like that should put a fire under somebody's ass. And Kandi just sitting there like, ooh, okay, like, all right, mom, but don't get up here and do all that. No, first of all, they shouldn't be disrespecting your aunts and mom anyway. Like, where is Kandi this season? Like, because Kandi, she knows how to run things. Like, when I tell you when things ain't working out and she gets in her way of thinking, because we've seen Kandi. I don't know, child. I really don't know. But anyway, let's see. What else we had going on that happened there? So yeah, they went to the aunt's house. We meet the planner, the event planner that ended up quitting because they made him do another position. That they made, I guess they made him general manager for a certain extent. And then he was like, no, I'm just an event planner. Like, I'm not doing this. You know, like, what? Like, if he's, I can't stand when jobs do that too. Cause I remember when you get, cause I've done a couple internships or whatever, and I signed on for a certain position cause I'm good at that certain position, but they had me do some other thing. I'm like, what is this? Like, no. So I understand why he left, but he's coming back to do more events for them cause they were doing the OLG reunion, which was going to bring all, or most of the original employees that were there. So we meet Brian and he had on his toupee or whatever. He was not lying about that. I'm like, he did not have to say that, child, because I would have never known it was a toupee. I don't know. Maybe y'all was able to clock him. I was not able to clock him. But I'm like, child, you done told it yourself. But anyway, he over here handing out egg rolls. He over here handing out egg roll menus for his. I'm like, child, this is... Who child the ghetto? Wouldn't he say? No, but he's funny, and I think that he's gonna bring it. I don't know what position he's coming back for. Like, was he a cook? Because I mean, I guess because he got egg rolls. I don't know. Tell me what y'all think. Because I think I missed that. I don't know what his role was. We also met Rashawn. He was a hostess at Blaze, and he's kind of, you know, uppity and, you know, black bourgeois and all this and third. I don't know how he's going to fit into the show, but I guess it works because it's just going to bring, it's like a melting pot of different personalities. So that might be good for a show. Child, not me dropping stuff, but I don't know. I mean, he's cute. Let me just say this. Look, a lot of the guys on here, they can freaking get it. They really can. I mean, look, a lot of people say Philip look good. A lot of people say Brandon look good too. Yeah, I don't know about Rashad or Bryant, but Rashawn. That one, oh my goodness. Let me tell you. No, but they look good. And I think that, you know, him coming back being the hostess, I think he's gonna take Shandrika's job because I don't see her lasting. Like, they're gonna use her for a couple episodes. And she's been talking very vocally when this season came out. Like, she's been saying a lot of stuff, you know, talking crap about, I think, Philip and stuff like that, and like the managers. Like, yeah, we might not see too much from her after this season. I mean, even if this season is to go into the next, like, yeah, I don't know, child. But anyway, we see Rashawn's first day of OLG, and like many days, it was a goddamn mess. We got people waiting for hours. We got the lights done turned off. I'm like, it's hot as hell over there. I'm like, child, like I said, like them long lines, let my fat ass been outside waiting hours upon hours. Now, at some point, and someone, one of my mutuals said this on YouTube, like, at some point, you're going to have to, like, Kandi, you're going to have to move. And you're going to have to move to a bigger space or a space that, you know, the power ain't gonna come off. Like, the power went off. Like, what are we doing? And then we see y'all, you and Todd in the confessional talk about some, oh, well, you know, we don't want to go through the proper channels to get the generator because it's too much work. But that's what you, like, it really be, okay, I get it. Like, y'all got money, this, that, and the third, and y'all feel like y'all could just throw some, something, throw water at something and it'll grow, but you have to put in the work also. Like, what do you mean you don't want to get a generator? Like, y'all not even strapped for cash like that to be, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's businesses that, you know, they weren't rich, you know, creating this restaurant or whatever business they made, and they're able to, you know, stand the test of time. It's just like, your name is not going to get you that far, honey. You got to make sure, like, at some point people going to be like, but y'all don't care if it's candy. I'm just going to stop coming here. And I'm not saying that's going to happen, like, to you, because, you know, you are people going to show up regardless because they want to see you because you always there. And that's another problem. Candy is there too much. I feel like I feel like the scenes that she should have, it should be with her family, stuff like that. Like, I ain't got a problem with her going over to her aunt's house or her, you know, seeing people and stuff like that, doing her own thing. But you are at this restaurant too much. Now, somebody confirm with me in the comments, because I'm not sure. Was Lisa Vanderpump always there? And I'm sorry to compare, but I mean, it's kind of similar to Vanderpump Rules. But, like, was Lisa always there at the bar? Like, I felt like I only seen her a couple of times, and we see Candy too much. Like, if we're seeing you too much, that means there's too much shit going on at your restaurant, and you need to get that shit together, okay? I think, you know, I guess just to give the final thoughts, because I'm almost at 20 minutes, child. I did not just expect to do 15. But I think that character's good. I like everybody on there, even Chandrika, because I feel like everybody, like, a show needs its villain, or I'm not going to say she's a villain, but a show needs, like, a person that's just going, you know, be extra and stuff like that, right? We obviously need people like Philip, because Philip is going to shake things up, and I think he's going to get into it with Candy, and I think that Candy needs this conversation. I just hope that she doesn't, because usually sometimes Candy will just shut down a whole conversation just because, oh yeah, I don't, and not you coming for me. I'm like, yeah, he coming for you. Like, I like what Philip said in his confessionals. It's like, you know, it's kind of unprofessional for me to be managing your establishment, and you don't even have the proper, you don't even have a generator if X, Y, and Z happens. You get what I'm saying? Like, and at that point, it's not a hostess, it's not a bartender, it's not like the cook's problems at that point, because it's like, what can we do? We don't pay the bills. That's not our field. You know, their asses should have got a damn generator. Okay, and I'm pretty sure Candy got a couple generators in that damn mansion that they live in. You seen that mansion when they first pulled up? I'm like, sheesh, Lord, okay, gated community. Look, I know they got plenty generators. They could have wheeled that thing over at that restaurant. I think they need to get a bigger restaurant soon, because it's too many people. Like, it's too many people for that little area. Like, it's, I don't know, child. But the first episode was interesting. We seen like a sneak peek of the entire season. We'll see what happens. And, you know, I'll probably be on this again, talking about it next week. So until next time, I am your host, Aaron Green, and this is TDGS Reviews.